Now that we understand what climate change is and what it's doing to our planet, a natural question to ask would be, well, how do we really know all this stuff for sure? It's hard to accept all of these complex ideas and facts being thrown at you, without even being a little skeptical. How can we really be sure that our greenhouse gas emissions are really the root cause of climate change? Well, we actually have a lot of evidence to support this claim. Why don't we start with the most obvious facts? We've known since the early 1900s that when we burn carbon-based materials, such as coal or oil, CO2 is released, or carbon dioxide. We've also known since the 1850s that CO2 is able to trap heat. Now, if you watched our last video, you'd know that this is why CO2 is called a greenhouse gas. We've actually been collecting data about what we burned since the 70s, and therefore have a pretty good idea of how much CO2 we've released into the atmosphere since then. In addition to this, we are also able to measure the parts per million of CO2 in our atmosphere. This is just a fancy way of saying how many CO2 particles there are in a million particles of air. This fact is important, actually, because we've been able to measure the parts per million of CO2 for the last 800,000 years. But wait, how is it even possible to know how much CO2 there was so far back in the past? Well, we know this from studying ancient ice cores. Scientists working at the poles drill very far down into the ice to collect ice cylinders. These so-called ice cores contain tiny bubbles of air trapped inside. The deeper the core, the older the gas bubbles. By analyzing these tiny trapped bubbles of air and knowing how deep they were, we can learn about the concentrations of CO2 in the air at a given time in the past. Pretty neat, huh? Because of these ice cores, we can be pretty sure that the concentration of CO2 in our atmosphere today is higher than it has been in the past 800,000 years. We also know that the rate at which the parts per million of CO2 is increasing is higher than past rates. Unconvinced by this historic data? Well, why don't we look at something more recent? Today, scientists across the globe have set up measuring towers and ocean buoys to record global temperatures 24/7. And guess what? These temperatures have been steadily rising. What's more, photos from satellites orbiting the Earth are showing the effects of a warming world. We've seen glaciers retreating, reduced snow cover, a declining in Arctic sea ice, and a resulting rise in sea levels. Clearly, our world is changing, but how do we know it's the fault of humans? Well, thanks to recent advances in computer technology, we are now able to model our changing climate fairly accurately. By using supercomputers to account for hundreds of different variables, researchers have been able to model and predict the effects of different events on our environment. From these models, it's quite clear that the global changes we are seeing right now cannot be explained by natural phenomena, meaning they must be human-caused. We here at Climate Science are devoted to creating accessible, factual, and engaging content to educate others on how we can all work to fix climate change. Keep an eye out for our upcoming videos on solutions to climate problems, and make sure to subscribe if you like our content.